Like many of you, I have lost count of the number of times where we have been in a situation where Bungie has disappointed and thoroughly pissed off the Destiny community. From the inferior consumable shader system, the numerous instances of throttled XP and rewards, the loot box focused events, the lack of substantial content, removal or poor implementation of basic quality of life features, to misguided adjustments to core gameplay mechanics, Destiny 2 has been nothing short of a train wreck since launch. Now, Bungie has been on track to improving Destiny 2 throughout 2018, by which I mean that they're slowly inching their way back to making the game be more like Destiny 1, especially with their latest update called the Go Fast update. The whole point of it was to speed up the game's overall pacing for both PvE and PvP by significantly boosting mobility. For PvP in particular, one of the biggest qualms has been its high time to kill, or TTK. It simply takes too many shots to kill someone in competitive multiplayer matches, which slows down the mode's pacing, makes it too easy for players to react to flanks and ambushes, and makes it difficult to take on multiple players at a time. In other competitive shooters like Call of Duty, Battlefield, Titanfall, you name it, the TTK is low enough where if you get the jump on the enemy, they might as well be as good as dead, but in Destiny 2, the high TTK means that the value of strategic approaches is drastically decreased. So for months now, the feedback from the community has been very clear. Decrease the TTK, make it easier and faster for players to kill each other to accelerate gameplay flow. It doesn't have to be Call of Duty level per se, but TTK is simply too high right now. Now, this was feedback that Bungie claimed to have heard in an update from all the way back in March 8th, 2018, which featured a segment that read, quote, "Does this mean you're changing the time to kill? When we looked at the core feedback on time to kill in the Crucible, we saw that it mostly stemmed from a lack of excitement or spikes of intensity you all came to expect from a Destiny experience. This came in the form of feedback that stated the game was too slow or the core loop was too stale. We agree and have worked with Sandbox to increase the pace of the Crucible as a whole." Looking at this, the assumption was that the issue would be addressed with the latest Go Fast update, but the segment of the Destiny community who anticipated PvP and TTK adjustments was met with disappointment. While the update did mark a step in the right direction in certain areas, particularly where PvE is concerned, the general consensus is that the update doesn't go far enough for how long it's been cooking in the oven, particularly where PvP is concerned. So here's everything that the update completely failed to address. This list of bullet points was compiled by website Forbes, which did a good job in highlighting all of the main criticisms raised in forums and social media. The first one is a really big one. Despite the fact that the Go Fast update was supposed to make players, well, go faster, Bungie opted to not increase the game's sprint speed, which is how Destiny 2 players move 95% of the time. While it is nice that mobility was sped up in other areas like walking, jumping, and some super moves, that doesn't make it any less baffling that an update that was supposed to address the game's slow pacing by increasing movement speed didn't so much as touch the one form of movement that players spend most of the time with. That's not to say that players don't feel improvement on numerous fronts, especially in PvE, but for many this feels like a half measure. From there, the next bullet point lists how while the Titan and Warlock classes got some significant boost to their jumps, Hunters, the game's mobility class, did not. One Reddit post summarizes this issue perfectly in more extensive detail, stating, quote, "With the Go Fast update, I was expecting my Hunter's mobility points to actually mean something. Sure, I walk around a bit faster, but everyone still runs at the exact same speed as before. To top it all off, however, the Warlocks and Titans can now surpass their ground sprint speed by using their upgraded air boosts, Warlock gliding, Titan skating. Hunters, ironically, didn't get any changes to their jumping mobility options. Strafe jump feels the same, slow laterally, as does triple jump, no increased momentum. Hunters, whom are supposed to be the most mobile of the three, are the slowest ones around. This just doesn't make any sense to me. Why can't sprint be tied to our mobility stat, allowing people who invest points into it to, I don't know, actually run faster? At the very least, Hunter should have their jump mobility options buffed as well so they aren't literally left behind." Next up, while people were glad to see the return of Rumble, a free-for-all PvP mode, changing it so that it's now 8 players meant that it's just not what it used to be, with overcrowding and bad spawns getting in the way of the experience. Then we have the big one. The game's TTK has remained untouched in PvP, so it's still too easy for players to escape death and too hard to secure kills. It's a bizarre omission considering that this is probably the most requested fix as far as PvP is concerned, and instead of addressing the issue directly, Bungie's solution seems to have been to tiptoe their way around it by suggesting that increased mobility, one that doesn't even boost the game's most used form of movement, sprinting, would somehow mitigate the issue. One Reddit post put it bluntly in an open message to Bungie, stating, quote, "Decrease the TTK. If you happen to be employed by Bungie at the moment, let me rephrase, decrease the fucking TTK. That is what Destiny players have asked for literally thousands of times, and that is what you need to do. Please do not blue curtain this, and do not go faster this by, again, overestimating your literacy or underestimating ours. Please don't interpret decreased TTK to mean that Destiny players really want a roast beef milkshake, an inflatable ass paddle, involuntary organ donations, or something truly absurd such as a speed increase that doesn't actually increase sprint speed. It boggles the mind, a go faster update that completely overlooks the primary action one normally takes to go faster." Clicking on the linked blue curtain text will send you to this image showing a Venn diagram that aptly represents the current sentiment of the Destiny community. Blue is what the author of a book, or in this case, Destiny players meant, and green is what your English teacher, or in this case Bungie, thinks the author meant. The example provided is when the author says the curtains were blue, the teacher might go into some long-winded roundabout explanation and interpretation, when the author simply meant that the curtains were fucking blue. This really is the Destiny 2 journey in a nutshell. They've always been about assuming what players want, assuming that they know what's best for us, rather than just sitting down and listening to what their community is actually saying in very simple terms. And it's absolutely no different with the issue of the game's high time to kill, despite constantly saying that they're listening to feedback, and despite recently having said that they agree with complaints regarding TTK. Instead of tackling the problem head on, they've instead come up with a roundabout solution that doesn't actually solve anything. Anyway, Forbes list finishes things off by citing things like slow progress when it comes to game updates, with features like weapon slotting and random rolls being slated for fall 2018, as well as how the game is still essentially trying to roll back to be more like Destiny 1, the prequel. The way I've described it before is that Destiny 2 is a marathon runner who finally realized that they've been running in the wrong direction and is only now starting to make its way back to the starting line, though at an unprecedentedly sluggish pace. The sluggish pace in particular is something that website Destructoid described best in a recently published article titled, "Destiny 2's incredibly slow patch cycle is an anomaly in a swiftly moving landscape." The article compares how an issue that might take Bungie's Destiny 2 weeks to acknowledge and communicate and months to fix will take, say, Epic's Fortnite or Digital Extremes Warframe days to acknowledge, communicate, and fix, noting how the anomaly lies with Bungie, not with the other titles. The closing paragraph describes the situation perfectly, stating, quote, "Bungie could immediately turn this franchise around by talking about the big, glaring problems that Destiny 2 has openly, instead of periodically posting 'We are listening' on Reddit and heavily prepared, brief, flowery update blogs. The whole 'we're not addressing the elephant in the room because we know what we're doing' style of development is an archaic way of doing things, and Bungie is suffering because of it. It doesn't help that they take months to deploy balance fixes that its competitors can roll out in days, but they still haven't made good on their promise to actually communicate." I couldn't have said it better myself, and this couldn't be more apparent than with the go faster update, slow release, and key omissions. We are almost 6 months into Destiny 2's release at this point, and while the game has been making progress, things have been moving far too slowly for players' liking, and updates continue to be too minor for the rate at which they're being released. It really begs the question of whether it'll be worth waiting until the end of the year just to finally get an experience that resembles a prequel, just to get back to the starting line again, especially when there are plenty of other shared world action games out there that dish out updates faster, more substantially, and are currently in a much better state. The first Destiny might have been the first game of its kind, but the landscape has changed drastically since then with the introduction of competing franchises. With Destiny 2 rapidly falling behind, half-measure improvements every couple weeks or months may not cut it if Bungie hopes to catch up and remain competitive. Anyway, with that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content, consider supporting me on Patreon. It is completely optional, but donating even as little as a dollar a month will go a long way in helping this channel grow. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out!